Do you agree with the Nakshwani now or the Nakshwani that existed back in 2012? Because that Nakshwani seemed to understand.
Know that disunity is a virus in our community. For example, us, the followers of Ahlul Bayt, we have a couple of Mawlanas on YouTube. One wears a white turban, the other wears a black turban. You find them on YouTube attacking the companions of Rasulullah publicly, cursing with the filthiest language. And the problem is, when a person looks at this on YouTube, he doesn't know the difference between who's really a scholar and who's not. You look and all you see is someone who looks like a Mawlana or a teacher or a scholar of the school of Ahlul Bayt, giving the filthiest language with the filthiest rhetoric.
And they were now the henchmen for the first Khalifa, Gaddafi or Saddam, for example. If they have someone who doesn't pledge allegiance to them, we used to all speak out against them, didn't we? All of us used to say these dictators of Islam. Why then a rule for Saddam and Gaddafi and not a rule for the terrorist government at the beginning of the religion of Islam? Yes?
And you find that instead of people speaking out against them, but you know he's a Mawlana and I can't really say anything. The moment you see a Mawlana sit on the member of Al Muhammad who's causing disunity between Muslims, pull him off. Pull him off!
The best description in terms of physical appearance would be that when Omar would walk on one side of the road, Shaytan would go on the other. Yep. A woman would miscarry her baby when pregnant when she saw Umar ibn Khattab's face. So that should give you enough of an indication as to his physical appearance.
Don't let a person like this stay. Do you know how many lives we lost in Pakistan because of Mawlanas who would come and speak filthily about others and people innocently got killed? The best doctors of the community got killed. The best intellectuals got killed. Why? Because that person doesn't think of the Muslim Ummah, he thinks of himself. Am I entertaining my crowd? Are they showing me entertainment back? Then yes, then I'll continue. Think about those brothers in Saudi Arabia who don't know how to get home because of your lecture. Think of those brothers in Pakistan who get beheaded because of your lecture. When Ali ibn Abi Talib brought this message, he said, remove your differences and strengthen your ties. Not strengthen your differences and remove your ties. Ali ibn Abi Talib is dying. And he's saying, remove your differences and strengthen your ties as Muslims. And we have people who claim to be followers of Al Muhammad. The moment you see a Mawlana sit on the member of Al Muhammad who's causing disunity between Muslims, pull him off. Pull him off. Pull him off. Pull him off.